advisor, as a mentor, a coach, a lot of times the sales team managers. I'm not a sales guy. I just tend to understand people dynamics. That's what I work with. The most frequent cause for failure I've seen on sales teams is lack of alignment of expectations. You hire a person that's got a great track record in sales. You can look at what they've accomplished. Great stuff. You can look at what their earnings were from commissions. Great stuff. But if you hire them for the wrong job and have different expectations than the one they're used to delivering on, you got the potential for a train wreck. If you haven't been clear about what your expectations are with this position, and you haven't painted clearly the picture of success for that individual, you're running the risk of a lack of alignment. Clear lack of alignment, Matthew alluded to earlier. I grew up in banking in the 70s and 80s, and that was that period of transition where bankers had to learn that to be successful, they had to be in sales. Bankers at that time were old school. You come to me because you trust me. I'm the banker in town. Of course you're going to come to me. And they would sit in their office waiting for people to come and bring their financial needs, bring their lending needs, bring their money for investment, and you're just kind of sitting there waiting for people to come. Well, guess what? That wasn't working so well anymore. Talk about a lack of alignment of the needs and expectations and the expectation of what that person had in their head for success completely removed. Those bankers that were successfully made the transition from the 60s to the late 80s were people that could get their heads wrapped around something different was needed, and they could make the shift. Now, could they make the shift on their own? Very few did. They made the shift through effective coaching about what successful behaviors in this new environment are going to look like. So when you hire a salesperson, one of the starting points is think about what are your needs in your company? What kinds of sales? Is it important just to get that transactional sale, or is there an ongoing relationship that needs to be cultivated and developed because there's more opportunity for repeat business and repeat sales and extended relationship, the doctor relationships? If so, you want to paint a picture of what that looks like for that person. Because the person who's used to coming in and selling a cell phone deal over the counter and be done and gone and moved on to the next one, because all they're interested in is getting paid a commission on that particular transactional sale, is probably not going to be the best person to cultivate the long-term relationships. So you need to paint the expectation of, in our business, the long-term relationship of repeat sales, repeat business, expanded relationship is important as service after the sale is important as getting the closing the deal. The next thing you then need to do is be prepared to effectively coach. What are the behaviors you need? How do you get people to execute on those behaviors? Do you really understand what the behaviors are that you need to coach to? Mike will tell you, if you don't understand the behaviors that convert to success, you're starting in a hole. You need to understand the behaviors and coach to the behaviors and train to the behaviors. The last thing is accountability. If you're sitting there just saying, I've hired a great rainmaker, great success, let him go, but you haven't set up any metrics, there's no accountability, guess what? I love salespeople. Love them to death. But some of the best people are really good because they have persistence. They don't get phased. They're moving on to the next deal. One of the things that makes them good is they're a little bit like ducks. Water rolls off their back. The other thing that makes them good is they're always looking for the next thing. Their attention spans can be like the attention span of a flea. Bless their little hearts. I love them to death. But they get attracted by the next shiny object. Richard knows that. The next shiny object, they're off and down chasing that one. If you're the manager, you've got to help keep them focused. focus sometimes. Bring them back to the behaviors. Bring them back to accountability. Are they getting the results that's aligned with the company's needs? Because they'll be going out doing great things has nothing to do with what your business needs to do. But they're doing great things, but it's not helping you move your business forward. So those are three keys I would encourage.